Hello friends, today I will introduce to you how to use a new test fixture, the Pico BT Universal Test Fixture, which can test a variety of hash boards and PSUs. This video mainly demonstrates testing Antminer S9 hash board with Pico BT Tester. First of all, I will introduce the tools and software needed to use the test fixture. This is our Pico BT Universal Test Fixture. This one is the USB connection cable of the tester. When we use the test fixture for the first time, we need to use it to install the test files. T9 Plus Riser, used to test Antminer T9 Plus hash board. M3 Riser, for testing WatsMiner M3 hash board. Next, we need to learn about the ports on the test fixture, and these function keys will be explained in detail during the test demonstration. This is the switch of the test fixture. 6P power port. WatsMiner hash board connection port. Antminer hash board connection port. Test file installation port. Oscilloscope probe port. InnoSilicon hash board connection port. Cheetah and iSheen miner hash board connection port. At this time, I will introduce the power interface on the upper end of the tester. This is the InnoSilicon PSU port. iSheen miner PSU port. Antminer PSU port. WatsMiner PSU port. This is an oscilloscope probe, which can be used to test the signal. DC 12 volts PSU, used to power the test fixture and hash board. Adjustable voltage PSU, which is used to supply power to the hash board of the integrated miner. Of course, the own PSU of the miner can also be used. Double rows of cooling fans. It is necessary to dissipate heat for the hash board when testing. Then, we started to connect the USB cable to the test fixture and computer, ready to download the software and install the test files. This is the installation software for using the Pico BT test fixture. Unzip the file first, and then click Install. Okay, the installation is complete. Let's install the test file first. Open the test fixture software. Click here to start connecting the test fixture. Click Open File. Select the test file. And then click Program Verify to start programming and verify the test file. After completion, the test fixture will restart, and the interface of the test software will display OK, indicating that the file has been programmed successfully, and the test fixture can be used normally at this time. Following, I will start to demonstrate how to use the Pico BT test fixture to test the Antminer S9 hash board. First, use 12 volts DC PSU to power the hash board and test fixture respectively. And then use 18P data cable to connect the hash board and test fixture. Turn on the test fixture switch. and turn on the cooling fan at the same time. Look, the display screen of the test fixture has shown the models of a Netminer hash board, WattsMiner hash board, and InnoSilicon hash board that can be measured. These green buttons here are used to select the brand of the hash board, while the blue buttons are used to select the model of the hash board to be measured. The white one is the test button, and the red one is the return button. When we press the white button, we can enter the test interface. After entering the test interface, these buttons will have different functions. The green button on the top is used to select the test mode. Mod means to test the ASIC chips of the hash board. And MD2 means to test the temperature sensing circuit of the hash board. The below one green button is used to select the number of tests. Selecting 1 means only one test, while 999 means that the test can be repeated many times, which is beneficial for us to test the voltages. The blue button on the right is used for PIC switching. Select PC0. The RST signal will remain low level at 0 volt on the hash board. But select PC1. The RST signal will remain high level at 1.8 volts on the hash board. Usually we only need to select the PIC mode. Okay, let's start testing. Select Mod mode. Press the white button to start the test. 63 here means that the test fixture found 63 ASIC chips. Select MD2 mode. Press the white button to start the test. The sensor here represents the temperature sensor chip, and the following number represents the test data. Chip 62 represents the ASIC chip corresponding to the temperature sensor chip, and the following number also represents the test data. Finally, I will show you how to test the RI signal of the hash board. We can only test the RI signal with an oscilloscope probe. Mode 999 needs to be selected for testing. Connect the probe to the test fixture. Select the 999 mode. Which domain's RI signal is tested? We should clamp the probe clip on the corresponding heat sink and connect the probe to the RI test point. Press the test button to start the test. Please look at here. The number here has been increasing, which means that the test fixture is repeatedly testing the hash board. It is convenient for us to test the RI signal. Start testing the RI signal. The probe is connected to the RI signal test point, and the clip is connected to the corresponding negative pole. If the number 9 is displayed on the test fixture, it means that the RI signal from the 63rd chip back to the 55th chip is normal. If the number 7 is displayed, you need to continue to test backwards according to the transmission direction of the RI signal, until you find the chip with an abnormal RI signal. Well, the above is the content of testing the S9 hash board with the PicoBT multifunction test fixture. We will continue to update the video of using this fixture to test other hash boards. You can also view more detailed usage manual on our official website. See you in the next video.